Now, if I told you we were going to have the inventor of Chop Saver on, you'd be thinking, great, I can turn potatoes into french fries in a matter of seconds. I can cut a tomato so thin, my in-laws will never come back. Not the case. I'm here with professional musician Dan Gosling. He is the inventor of Chop Saver, but this is not what it's not. It's for your chops.
It's for your chops.
As in the musical sort of
right.
slang for...
Musicians call their lips their chops. Several years ago, a former student of mine and dear friend told me how he treated a lip injury that he incurred in a marching band situation. So imagine you're in marching band playing trumpet and somebody runs into
you. I'm going to guess it was a percussionist because that's usually what in marching, they're usually responsible for injuries to horn players.
I'm not sure who the perpetrator was, but... So he has this horrible bruise on his lips, and he uses an herb called arnica.
Arnica.
To treat the injury.
Okay.
And he's just telling me this story, and I never heard of arnica myself. But he said it was such a miraculous healing that I thought, this is too good an idea to just a few people to know about. So I set out to create a product specifically for musicians, for people that use and abuse their lips on a daily basis.
Sure, exactly.
Arnica is one of the key ingredients, but through trial and error, quite literally in my kitchen, came up with this.
You went all mad scientist in your kitchen?
Yeah, I think we got some pictures I hope you can show.
Did you even had any attempted anything like this ever before?
No, no. I'm a 25-year professional trumpet player.
Okay.
I had no idea about inventing a product, let alone starting a business.
Sure.
That's all the other part of the story.
Okay. there you go.
Yeah.
In the process.
That's me. My wife thought I'd kind of lost my mind for a while.
How many different combinations did you go through? Did you hit on
probably
that route really quickly?
Close to 20.
Oh man!
Until I got this was a period of about 6 to 8 weeks.
How did you test it?
First on myself.
Okay. All right.
And the first couple were horrible. Okay. It's amazing that I kept going with this idea, and finally got to the point where they were not bad, and I started trying them on family, my wife and son, and then I tried them on my colleagues, and they all said, this is the best stuff I've ever used. What is this?
That's
said,
great
well,
praise.
Well, it's something I'm working on.
I'm going to try it while
so
you're
So we've been selling it in music stores and online, chopsaver.com, and we're thrilled now that Kroger stores, Central Indiana Kroger stores.
Yeah, man, that makes it more accessible. And some of it even has an SPF in it.
Yeah, we added the sunscreen a few years ago. We actually have a dermatologist now recommend this product as a superior moisturizer.
Oh my gosh, that's incredible. My wife is always like, your lips don't get cracked in the winter. You get these massive fissures that look like National Geographic close-up of a desert area. But I think, especially this time of year, your story is incredibly inspirational because people have an idea or an occurrence in their life similar to yours. You didn't let it go. And I think we're looking with a new economy and the new normal where people are trying to be maybe a little more self-sufficient, a little more entrepreneurial.
Absolutely. And no, the idea wouldn't let me go. It was one of those things where I just couldn't not follow through with this. But I would say to anybody who has an idea, don't go to your grave with it. You know, take that next step. Take that next, talk to someone about it. Experiment. Google is an incredible thing. You can research your idea. You can find out if someone's already done it. You can see if the name that you've got in your mind is already taken, things like that you couldn't even, would have taken you months of research can now be done in a matter of minutes. And you can be that much farther ahead in your entrepreneurial journey.
Well, would you say your mindset helped as well? Because you said the idea didn't let you go, but you didn't go dry wash your hands. Oh, I've got $1 million idea. Yeah. You're like, this is an idea that can benefit people that you come into contact with on a daily basis.
Right, right. And that's how I was able to test it so quickly and get the feedback that I needed so quickly. My colleagues in the community all said, whatever you're doing here, keep going with it. So I knew I was really onto something.
What was your time frame between, this has got to be something for more than just my student, and being able to really call it a product?
The idea happened, I can tell you the exact date, May 16th, 2004, and this product was on the market 6 months later.
Oh my gosh, that's an incredible turnaround.
It was a crazy...
Is some of this backstory on your website? You click on the about sometimes on a website, shows you the other side of the package.
Chopsaver.com, and there's also, we have a YouTube channel.
Oh, great.
YouTube.com/Chopsaver. Mm-hmm. There's videos on there, there's some me doing some speaking about entrepreneurship, a little bit of the backstory, things
That's
like
awesome,
that.
Especially, again, getting to the first of the year, this is the sort of thing, maybe the little oomph, some people need to take that idea that they've been sitting on, or the idea that has them, and take it. We're going to link to that on indiestyle.tv if you don't
mind.
Andy, would you like me to save you a tube?
Would you, well, yeah. Would you like for me to save you a slider?
I don't know.
You want a slider?
Sure.
Okay.
I just
chopped up my lips, though. They're all, so
you
I don't
did? Okay, well, then more sliders for me. Sorry about your luck, Tracy, but Chef Tony was just in from Capital Grill. We made these. Huh? You made these in the first segment, but what we have coming up next?
We have a oven-roasted cedar plank salmon. We have our fresh, it's marinated cedar planks and our wild...
That's a big old chunk of salmon.
Yeah, Atlantic salmon. We're going to do our fennel relish right on top, our fresh fennel relish we're making in-house. It's just going to be beautiful.
Oh, it is going to be beautiful. Gosh, which should I eat? Maybe I'll have some of both. Guys, but these recipes are going to be on anystyle.tv a little bit later on. Dan, I mean, you're over there with your instrument. I mean, maybe you could...
I was still up in the tube. I kind of neglected the horn.
Maybe do a little something.
Could you take us to break, Dan?
Sure.